Welcome back to Let's Play Starfield Blind. I'm with this Luatari. We're at the MAST Center. Vanguard something or other.
Look, you didn't hear it from me, but I got a tip. There's a way to hack the Vanguard exam and get yourself a better score.
Oh, yeah.
Grew up in Neon, so I get big cities, but one clean enough to eat off the pavement? That's new.
Please don't grind your gears at this guy.
I mean, I don't like the UC any more than the next guy, but they've got the credits. I really hope all this historical junk isn't gonna be on the test.
So these are the test, Vanguard, registration. They're all the same.
You enlisting too? I've always wanted to live in New Atlantis, but they only let citizens buy property, so here I am.
Alright, let's just save before I start messing with this. I crashed twice. Quite a while ago, but going into computers. Applicant name unavailable, current bounty unavailable. Welcome prospective applicant. Please speak to Commander John Tawala in the MAST lobby to begin the application process. Oh. Well, we got far with that one. Become part of a better future. The end of Earth. Wow. Oh, there's a thing.
In 2150, humanity learned the Earth's magnetosphere would collapse sometime in the next half century, eliminating all life on the planet. Decisive action was required, but the secure transport of an entire civilization would demand a new kind of cooperation, a new kind of courage, and a new kind of union. Thus, in 2159, the United Colonies were formed to make that journey possible. Just 1 year later, the Galileo, the first of many colony ships, touched down here on Jemison, beginning a new era of human history. The age of the United Colonies.
What are you doing in the dark here?
You here to enlist? Don't worry, none of this junk is on the exam.
Wasn't much junk to speak of. New factions rise. Oh. It's a museum here.
From their foundation, the United Colonies strove to provide all their citizens with opportunity, security, and peace. But there were those among the UC that still wanted something more. Independence. So in 2161, the UC issued the Centaurus Proclamation, granting UC citizens the right to settle distant worlds and form their own sovereign powers. It wasn't long before the first new faction, the Free Star Collective, was formally organized in 2188, later followed by House Varun, revealing themselves to the universe in 2230.
Interesting. Oh, we have a button here too.
It was only in 2230 that the faction known as House Varun first made contact with the rest of the settled systems. Founded by the passengers of a colony ship that had left New Atlantis and disappeared 4 decades earlier, House Varun was a faction unlike any other.
Was?
A theocracy dedicated wholly to the beliefs of its isolationist founder, Jinan Varun. House Varun initially made overtures of peace towards the rest of the settled systems.
Initially?
They claimed their only intention was to spread the word of their god, the Great Serpent. But none could have guessed that this worship might take the form of a bloody war, the Serpent's Crusade.
Hmm. Well, this reminds me of the outer worlds. The Free Star Collective.
The Free Star Collective was initially founded in 2188, when the citizens of Aquila banded together with the pleasure city of Neon in mutual defense. But in 2194, after the deployment of a UC medical star station in orbit around their world, the citizens of Naria also requested to join the collective. The resulting rise in tensions between the Free Star Collective and UC culminated in the Settled System's first intergalactic conflict, the Narion War. Despite a decisive victory by the UC, the colonies permitted the citizens of Narion to join the collective, forming the basis for the fiercely independent union that persists to this day.
Well, I never...
Look, I'm not supposed to be giving opinions on this stuff, but the UC's in a lot better hands these days than back before they signed the armistice.
The Narion War. The history of the Narion War. Beginning in 2196, the Narion War, humanity's first large-scale conflict among the stars, is remembered as a defining moment for the Settled Systems. As the first major conflict to make extensive use of grav-jump-enabled ships, the Narion War was less defined by key space battles and more by an extended cat-and-mouse interplay between the two powers, as the well-armed and professional UC Navy tried again and again to pin down the piecemeal but savvy Free Star fleet. Unable to strike the killing blow, the UC resorted to ever more severe tactics to try and drive the collective to capitulate, but without success. In fact, after many long years of war with little to show for it, even the populace of the UC itself began to turn against the cause, with protests roiling even New Atlantis, the citizenry demanding the war finally come to a humane close. So, when at long last the final blow was struck, when the UC Navy finally cornering and obliterating the Free Star fleet in 2216, it was a hollow victory. It was from the resulting negotiations, the Treaty of Narion, that the Settled Systems as we know them today emerged, both literally and figuratively. Despite winning the war, the UC found themselves in an unenviable position, painted as a brutal aggressor even in their home systems. So in the spirit of unity and lasting peace, the UC agreed to the demands of the Free Star Collective and the Narion settlers, whose collusion triggered the conflict in the first place, and handed over Narion to the Collective as they had requested at the start of hostilities, including the Clinic Medical Star Station, creating the as we know it to this day. In return, the UC demanded two concessions. The first was payment for damages done in the form of mineral rights on multiple worlds across the galaxy. The second, more significant demand was that no great faction may ever colonize more than three systems. The UC would have Alpha Centauri, Sol and Wolf, and the Free Star Collective Cheyenne, Voli, and Narion. The Free Star Collective agreed to those terms, creating and codifying into law the Settled Systems as we know them today. The Treaty of Narion has since become the foundation of all contemporary political relations, and its only official violation, the cause of the galaxy's greatest conflict, the Colony War. To learn more about the Colony War, please proceed to the Conflict Among the Stars mural. Serpent's Crusade. New factions. Conflict among the... Is that the one? It's telling us to see which one. Hold on. Conflict Among the Stars is over there. Okay. But first we have this one, the Serpent's Crusade.
2240, House Varun forces declared all-out war on the rest of human civilization, initiating the Serpent's Crusade. The next 23 years, Thousands of Freestar, UC, and independent souls were killed by agents of House Varun in the name of their serpent god. It was
nice of them.
The death of their founder in 2263 and the succession of his heir, Jarek, that House Varun finally sued for peace.
Well, now they want peace.
There remains, however, select members of House Varun who refuse to recognize the cessation of hostilities their leaders established. Even after House Varun's mysterious disappearance, these zealots remain a threat to all who encounter them. Their pacification, a goal of all space.
Oh. Want to see what's back there. Conflict among the stars.
Of the many conflicts between the galaxy's factions, none was more brutal than the recent colony war between the UC and the Freestar Collective. Set off by the unauthorized Freestar colonization of Vesta's Pride in 2308, a direct violation of the Nerion Treaty, the colony war spread quickly across the galaxy. Both sides deployed every tool at their disposal. Armadas of warships, mechanized combat platforms, or mechs. Even bio-engineered alien creatures. The infamous UC Xeno weapons.
Oh yeah?
It was only in 2311 at the Battle of Cheyenne that the scales finally tipped.
Terror Morph.
The Freestar Collective, utilizing their civilian fleet as a human shield, successfully crippled the superior United Colonies Navy. After their shocking victory against the galaxy's greatest navy, the Freestar Collective offered terms of peace, which the colonies, out of an interest in staving off any further human costs, accepted. The galaxy has been rebuilding ever since.
Yeah. Wow. That's a big one. The Battle of Nera.
Few settled worlds were left untouched by the colony war. But nowhere could the viciousness of modern warfare be seen more clearly than on the Freestar planet of Nera. Initially occupied by invading United Colonies forces as a forward operating position, repeated attempts to take and retake the planet by collective forces led only to devastation. Swaths of the world were transformed into scorched husks, a nightmarish testament to the depths of human ingenuity and human cruelty. And today, Nera remains a continuing reminder to the horrors of unfettered war.
Indeed.
You think the Freestar Collective's got a place like this? Probably take too many bribes to get it off the ground.
I don't know, but that was a cool moonwalk you did. Was it the? Is this the terror thing?
I really hope this is just a phase.
One of my slates said Terramorphs can control people's minds. But that can't be true.
I don't think it would be. I mean, it's bad enough without being mind-controlling.
No one knows how they move between planets. I wonder if they can grav jump or something.
They move between planets.
I bring her here almost every day to stare at this thing.
Do not touch. Looks like something from The Thing. The Terror of Londinian?
Dad wanted me to apply for the administration track at school, but I'm going to be a xenobiologist. Science division or nothing.
Alright, follow your dreams, kid. Okay, the Terror of Londinian.
In the midst of the colony war, a different kind of tragedy struck the UC city of Londinian. A newly constructed but critical supply center for the United Colonies war effort, Londinian found itself overrun by one of the galaxy's most mysterious predators, the Terramorph. A rare but pervasive threat to all human-settled worlds, Terramorphs swept over the city, seemingly out of nowhere, on a scale never before seen in recorded history. Valiant efforts by the UC military slowed the onslaught, but the creatures proved unstoppable. Ultimately, the decision was made to destroy the Londinian spaceport, sealing off the city, the outbreak, and its citizenry from the galaxy at large. The tragedy of Londinian is mourned by the UC to this day.
Wow. Nothing but smoking ruins left, huh? The entire episode is just going to be this museum thing. The Armistice.
After the devastation wrought by the colony war, the UC and the Freestar Collective came together to ratify a treaty that became known as the Armistice. Both sides agreed to a vast reduction in standing forces, and that xeno weapons and mech warfare would be outlawed. All related research was sealed away, accessible only in cases of dire emergency. But the Collective had another demand: that the active commanders of the UC military stand trial for their actions. The United Colonies, in the interest of peace and galactic security, agreed. In 2311, three United Colonies senior officers were found guilty. Commander Henry Durant, General Indira Rastogi, and Fleet Admiral Francois Sanon, known better as Ve Victis. All were sentenced to death for their actions, bringing the colony war to a close, and returning peace to the galaxy at long last.
Why does that last guy have two names? Ve Victis. What does it say? By order of Armistice Article 13-61A. There shall be established a central archive guarded by three parties, the Freestar Collective, House Varun, and the United Colonies, for the collection and protection of all knowledge, research, and documentation depicting, describing, or in any way related to the technologies and mechanisms banned by the Armistice. It shall be governed by the following laws. 1. Access to all information in this archive will be mutually managed by all three parties. Access is only permitted by unanimous agreement of authorized factional representatives. 2. The facility will be under the direct control of no sovereign nation, with no single party permitted to overrule the others. All decisions regarding matters pertaining to the archives must be unanimous. 3. Any attempt at unauthorized access will be considered an act of aggression against all parties. Each party commits to defend the others against such attempts. What'd that say? At the bottom? Notice 77-KXR. If you have questions, please contact MAST Public Relations Desk. Oops. We continue.
You didn't hear this from me, but those ecliptic mercenaries, the factions use them sometimes. Freestar Collective and UC both. It's why they give them a wide berth. Ask me, those murdering assholes should be blasted in the space dust.
Pretty strong opinion about that. Alright, so the Vanguard is born.
It was into this new world that the Vanguard was born. An official branch of the UC Navy, the Vanguard is the United Colonies Volunteer Fleet, serving a myriad of security, logistical, and reconnaissance roles. And after a sufficient length of service, UC citizenship is guaranteed to every Vanguard member. Open to all captains, regardless of origin, the Vanguard is leading the charge to protect and support the citizens of the United Colonies, wherever in the galaxy they may be.
Okay. Oh, hi.
You're looking for the exam room? Just down the hall.
Yeah, he's the same guy I talked to. The United Colonies citizen.
No one is born a United Colonies citizen. Only through service to the UC can one hope to earn one's citizenship. But the UC prides itself on taking care of its people. Cost of living controls mean citizens pay less than their foreign counterparts for needs big and small. All citizens are issued a grant upon joining to get themselves on their feet. And only UC citizens have the opportunity to purchase property, getting the chance to live in one of the most beautiful cities in the settled systems. By joining the Vanguard today, you too can begin earning your place here, in the heart of galactic civilization, as a citizen of the United Colonies.
I don't think you end up with a house like that, though. I think you live in one of those towers. Alright, very nice. Vanguard Pilot Simulator. I really want to sign up for this. Piloting simulator. Floor access restricted. Huh. Well, they said I had to talk to that guy in the lobby first. I mean, I don't know if I want to join them. I'm mostly just curious. Supposed to head to the lobby. Let's go. Let's look around the building though. Let's go to Cabinet Chambers and Interstellar Affairs.
Charge you for a DP in A and B, B and E, or what? Heaven forbid, in MS. But at least then we wouldn't have to worry about a VOP, am I right?
I only know what B and E is. Picking and entering.
Yes, what? Just once, they could assign me to Neon. That's not too much to ask.
Huh. A lot of computer expertise.
My file.
UC security doesn't appreciate being hacked, okay?
I didn't hack anything. You can't see my file. I'm just walking past you.
Pardon?
Strategic asset? More like a financial black hole. I don't know why we keep funding that.
Hello. The chief is never going to approve this deal. Wonder if I can propose some alternatives.
Oh, bat ball. His foot. Galactic Bat Ball Association. When did they start calling it Batball?
Hey.
Hey, hey.
Excuse me.
Excused.
Addy?
need to make sure all those reports are annotated by the end of the day.
Functionary Gershon's computer. Oh. This is unlocked elsewhere. Grapes.
Yes?
Yes. Got a lot of food over here. Grilled cheese sandwich, grapes, water, coffee. Oh, this is your place. Your seat, sorry. Oh, this is a take. The origin of species. What species? Chapter 1, Variation under Domestication. Included is a rather incomprehensible list of varieties of species. When we look to the individuals of the same variety or subvariety of our older cultivated plants and animals, one of the first points which strikes us is that they generally differ much more from each other than do the individuals of any one species or variety in a state of nature. When we reflect on the vast diversity of the plants and animals which have been cultivated and which have varied during all ages under the most different climates and treatment, I think we are driven to conclude that this greater variability is simply due to our domestic productions having been raised under conditions of life not so uniform as, and somewhat different from, those to which the parent species have been exposed under nature. Darwin's theory on the origin of species on Earth continues through 14 full chapters, ranging from biology to geography and everything in between. Any more books? Notebooks. That one doesn't open. Reactive gauge.
Okay. Hello. McIntyre's gonna have my ass if I can't find that file.
Desktop speakers, huh?
Radcliffe's requests are so over the top. Is she just toying with us?
Radcliffe.
These sentinels are making an already demanding job more difficult. I wish they wouldn't meddle in affairs best left to governments.
This guy's a diplomat? I can't always select these people. I have to go from this side. Chief Diplomat Solomon Yazin.
It's in all our best interest to set aside differences. Try to work together as much as we can.
He doesn't have much to say.
Hello.
I know I'm in an area I'm not supposed to be in, I think. Oh, cool. Narian, Voli, Valo, unconfirmed. Crix, Wolf, Talamare, Talaman, Alpha Centauri, Sol System, Death. Okay. A little death in there, huh? Just to liven things up.
Yes. Where's the background research on that guy? I know we sent someone to look into it.
You have very strange eyebrows. Well, that's this whole area. We haven't looked back here, have we? Nothing is beyond our reach when we work together. Some of these books aren't real. Do not approve what fell through here. It's like one of those sand sculpture things, right? Yeah, sand garden. Desktop fishbowl. Origami sculpture. Hi, Deputy Elizabeth McIntyre.
Appointments only.
Right. Interesting.
Hello.
Goodbye. Alright, so that's that.
Excuse me.
Excuse him. Anything good up in here? Pretty cool looking. No idea what it signifies. Ah, the council. I decree. Alright, so this goes back down to here. And this goes out. Goodbye, cool world. Wow.
Cool.
Whee. Ah, I want to see me fall all the way down. That. I guess if I hit
up there, huh? Space. Must be cool.
Yeah, you've heard of it. Where did I come in here? I guess if you're a member, then things open up. They actually talk to you more. I'm not sure. Defense, Research, Health, and Human Services Aegis. Aegis Intelligence Network. I just keep wandering into this area.
Yes. What? Aegis agents don't like spy jokes. Found out the hard way.
I keep going into these areas that are authorized personnel only.
Defense Research has about a dozen active contracts right now. We'll see which ones pan out.
Okay.
Pardon? Reliant Medical needs those samples. Never should have trusted that shipping company.
Doesn't seem to be anything in these that's of any interest. Sleepy?
Hey.
He just needs what? Oh boy.
That was approved?
Agent Plato.
The security of the United Colonies is every citizen's responsibility. But we try and do the bulk of the work.
You do?
I hope you're not here to report something. If you are, it means you've seen far too much.
Huh.